In this video I will show you how to make the vambraces. For this tutorial I use a few layers and I already made templates. So for example here we have the top layer or fourth layer. Here is the third layer, second layer and the first layer, and then we have the base. And I will make copies of all those layers twice onto a piece of nice antique leather. Alright, we have two copies of each shape right now, and also note that most layers are a little bit wider than the base layer. As you can see, just a little bit, and that's because once we're going to bend it, you need that extra width. Next I will give these shapes a dark brown color, so here I have some leather dye. And a tray with a sponge and some gloves. So let's put them to the side for a while. So first we'll do the tray. And then I'll put my gloves in. And then take the sponge. Put some dye on. And just rub it into the leather. The leather dye is dry now, and meanwhile it was drying, I also made four of those small belts, and we will attach them to the vambraces later on, but right now we will engrave them. To engrave those layers I will use templates, and here we have several of them. And for example I will use this kind of egg shape, so we with leather and lay it on top. And actually part of this will be covered once the vambraces are complete, so the engravings won't go all the way down. And now I have a stitch wheel and I will actually transfer it onto the leather by just rolling it over the lines. I will show you how it's transferred. So I will do this for most of these parts and engrave them using my Dremel and an engraving bit. Next I will attach the belts to the base pieces, and if we take a ruler I will measure them at about 1 inch of each corner. So we have a corner right here and right here, and we will mark 1 inch or 2.5 centimeters. And here's the end of the other corner. Mark it right here. and do it on the other side as well. Now get my punching pliers and punch some holes near to the edge. And then you have to bend a little bit of shit. And you have to put these belts on using some rivets. So you put one of these in. Side on, then the cap, then I will get a block of wood just to protect my table. Rivet tool and just hammer it into place. Now you can do another buckle right here and two straps on this side, and of course you have to do the other one as well, but you have to attach the buckle on the mirrored side. So if you have the buckle right here, you have to attach it on this side for the other frame brace base. And now we can put the base around our arms and secure it. Next I will get the, let's see, little X shapes, because this is the first layer that's going to be on top of the frame brace. Or the base, I mean. Let's see what the one is. Then I will set this to the right size. Yep. And then I will make a hole right here. Also one in the middle. And then I will get my frame brace and put it around my arm. Oh, you don't even have to put it around your arm. It'll also stay and shit like this. And now you lay this shape, and I have to make sure that the back side, and then bend it a bit. Now you have to make sure it's in the middle. That looks good. And then you mark the holes onto the base. For the other one as well. And then I will use my punching pliers to make some holes. And then I will attach the X shapes using some rivets. Next we will add the second layer, which are the big parts, and I will punch a hole right here. Right here. And then we get our fan braces again and close them. And then we will do the same as before, so I will bend this a bit. And then lay it over the fan brace. And then mark the holes. And then we will punch some holes. And attach some rivets to them. Right, and as you already guessed, we will add another layer. This time it's the pointy layer. And we will make a hole right here. And one on the other side. And you might need longer rivets for this part, because you need to go through two layers right here before you can attach this part. And finally we will add our last layer, and for this layer I will punch some holes right here. And here. Let's see. The fan braces are pretty much done. The only thing missing is the fur underneath them. And unfortunately I won't do it, because I don't have a fur right now, and honestly I don't really like to have the fur underneath it, so I won't do it. But if you want, you can make your own fur and put them underneath. Shouldn't be a problem. So that means the fan braces are done. This was my fan braces tutorial. Thanks for watching.